Thank you. meters per second.
Good morning from the International Space Station Flight Control Room in Houston, Texas. Two Japanese spaceflight participants and a veteran Russian cosmonaut are on their way to the International Space Station in the Soyuz MS-20 spacecraft for an arrival to the orbital outpost about 41 minutes from now. Leading the team here in Mission Control Houston today for rendezvous and docking is Flight Director Jeff Radigan. Teams here in Mission Control are a go for Soyuz final approach this morning. Flight controllers here in Mission Control Houston are working with their counterparts across the world in the Russian Mission Control Center in the town of Koryov on the outskirts of Moscow. As the Soyuz MS-20, carrying veteran cosmonaut Alexander Misurkin, now on his third flight to space, and Japanese spaceflight participants Yusaku Maezawa and Yozo Hirano are nearing the end of a four-orbit, six-hour journey to the International Space Station. With a docking scheduled to the Poisk module on the space-facing side of the Russian segment of the station at 7:41 a.m. Central Time, 8:41 a.m. Eastern. Their journey to the International Space Station began at 1:38 a.m. Central Time, 2:38 a.m. Eastern Time. For a flawless ascent, whether the launch pad was 26 degrees Fahrenheit with partly cloudy skies, received some in-cabin views. In the view on the right is Yusaku Maezawa and Soyuz Commander Alexander Misurkin in the center of your screen. About 8 minutes and 46 seconds after liftoff, the third stage shutdown and separation occurred on the Soyuz booster, and just seconds later, the Soyuz automatically commanded its solar arrays and navigational antennas to deploy. Since then, all of the engine firings to raise the orbit of the Soyuz vehicle to match that of the International Space Station have happened without any issue. If everything goes as planned, this will be an automated rendezvous. However, Soyuz Commander Alexander Misurkin in the center seat of the descent module of the Soyuz will be at the controls in the unlikely event that he would have to take over manual flying control of the Soyuz for its docking. Again, Russian cosmonaut Misurkin is on his third flight into space, seated to his left in this photo is Japanese spaceflight participant Yozo Hirano, and to his right is Yusaku Maezawa. The crew will spend almost 12 days on the orbital outpost conducting a program of activities that involves showcasing spaceflight back to the people of Japan. Maezawa and Murano are making their journey into space under a contract between Space Adventures and Roscosmos. Misurkin, Maezawa, and Hirano will not become expedition crew members, but rather Misurkin, a visiting crew member, and Maezawa and Hirano will be spaceflight participants. They will return to Earth on December 19th, U.S. time, December 20th, Kazakhstan time, in the MS-20 vehicle they are arriving in today.
Current range is 4 kilometers. Closing rate is 8 meters per second.
What's the point?
Copy.
Once the crew floats through the hatch later this morning, expected around 9:35 a.m. Central Time, the crew will be greeted by Station Commander Anton Shkaplerov and the rest of the Expedition 66 crew. From left to right on your screen, NASA astronauts Rajachari and Tom Marshburn, European Space Agency astronaut Matthias Maurer, Roscosmos cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Pyotr Dubrov, and NASA astronauts Kayla Barron and Mark Vandehei. Before we went on air today, Pyotr Dubrov aboard the station established a voice contact with Misurkin aboard the Soyuz.
Alexander, we don't have the video right now. What is the current range and range rate? Copy. Range is 3,200 meters and range rate is 8 meters per second, 1.71077. Copy. Everything is nominal.
As the Soyuz gets a bit closer to the International Space Station, it will conduct an automated fly around to precisely align its forward docking probe in the direction of the Poisk docking port. That fly around will start at a range of about 400 meters from the International Space Station. So the Soyuz will conduct that fly around before a brief period of station keeping to enable flight controllers in Koryov to take a look and make sure they're happy with the alignment of the Soyuz for its final approach and docking.
Standing by for the third orbital correction. That's affirmative. Current range is 2,500 meters. And range rate is 7.9 meters per second. Copy.
We're getting a view now from the data that the crew aboard the Soyuz is getting.
Maneuver confirmed. The station has moved to the right and down. Copy. Standing by for stabilization mode setup. Indication.
Once that docking occurs this morning, there will be a few moments to allow the relative motion between the two vehicles to dampen out against one another. That will initiate the retraction of the docking probe to bring the two docking interfaces firm against one another and initiate the closing of the hooks.
Current is 3 to 4.5, SKDT activation 4.87. Copy. And I confirm the maneuver. Current range is 1,800 meters and the closing rate is 4 meters per second.
I can see ISS.
I see the station on the video monitor screen. Copy. The SO in narrative confirmed. GSO 1, 2, 3, and 4. The station is at the center of the crosshairs, and the video monitor range is 1,600 meters, and range rate is 4 meters per second. Copy. Alexander. Per your discretion, you can switch to AGC mode. Copy. Thanks.
there's our first view of the Soyuz MS-20. Closing in on the International Space Station on the tail end of its four-orbit, six-hour journey.
1430, and the range rate is 3 meters per second. Copy.
The Soyuz and the International Space Station just flew into an orbital sunrise over the South Pacific. The Soyuz is currently conducting a series of impulse burns. Those burns are small thruster firings from the engine that will enable the Soyuz to more precisely fine-tune its course to the International Space Station.
Range is 1,220 meters, and the range rate is 3.8 meters per second. Copy. The station is at the center of the crosshairs. Yes, and we confirm that. We can see it on the video. That's good.
Again, good views from an external camera on the station of the Soyuz as it moves steadily toward its target on the Poisk module. Coming up on about 5 minutes from the flyaround of the Soyuz, again, that will come when the Soyuz is about 400 meters from the station. After the flyaround, there will be a brief period of station keeping to enable flight controllers and Korioff to take a look and make sure they're happy with the alignment of the Soyuz for its final approach and docking.
Range is 970 meters, range rate 2.6. Copy. Angular rates are decreasing. Range is 900 meters and range rate 2.5 meters per second. We are monitoring the PO operation.
Meters.
This is the range. Range rate is 2.3 meters per second. Copy. Current range is 800 meters. Range rate 2.1. And the PO operation LED is off. Omega is 4.71077. This is the value of the inaudible. Alexander. So, what do you think about the ISS image that you have on the monitor? I can only see the contour of the station, and the image itself is not very clear.
670 метров текущая дальность.
Current range is 670 meters.
Fast time. Could you call here?
The Soyuz MS-20. In view above a solar array aboard the International Space Station, carrying a veteran Russian cosmonaut and two Japanese spaceflight participants, now flying over the Pacific Ocean on their way to dock with the International Space Station.
Отлично.
Much better. Excellent. Current range is 580 meters, range rate 1.4 meters per second. Copy.
Now under 2 minutes away from the fly around by the Soyuz. Again, that milestone comes about 400 meters from the station.
Stand by for final approach. Envelope.
Current
range is 520 meters. Range rate is 1.44 meters per second. Copy.
The Soyuz MS-20 now under 500 meters away from the International Space Station.
Docking this. Накорд 463 метра. 450 метров текущая дальность.
Current range is 450 meters. Range rate is 1.4.
Принято.
Copy.
440 meters now separating the Soyuz from the International Space Station.
Range is 400 meters, and I confirm that that the mode has changed to that of fly around. Depot operation indication is on. Fly around plane is being generated. Range is 370 meters, and range rate is 1 meter per second.
And the fly around is now underway at a range of about 400 meters. All of these events happening right on the timeline, and everything is still proceeding as expected. Again, this fly around of the station will last for just a few minutes, resulting in station keeping for a brief period of time to enable the Russian flight control team to assess the vehicle's systems before they reinitiate the spacecraft's approach for contact and capture, scheduled for 7:41 a.m. Central Time, 8:41 a.m. Eastern.
Alexander, reminder, please monitor the K-15 parameter and please provide a running commentary.
And we're in a brief period of handover between satellites. We should be regaining these communications here shortly.
Altair, Moscow. Range is 300 meters. Range rate 0.65 meters per second. 290 meters. This is the current range, and range rate 0.65. Copy all.
Now about halfway through the fly around.
Current range is 270 meters, range rate 0.64.
Большой диаметр СМ около клетки.
SM large diameter is next to the square on the screen. Copy.
That next milestone of station keeping will come at about 210 meters. The Soyuz now 250 meters away from the International Space Station.
0.48 meters per second. Please report when you see that car 15 indication is illuminated. Yes, will do. Current range is 230 meters. Range rate is 0.3 meters per second.
Meters and closing.
Current range is 220 meters. Range rate is 0.17. Input 1, control panel input 1 is being rebooted. At 16:22:20, is that correct time of the reboot? Yes. And was it a random reboot? Yes, correct. Copy.
Вышли в верхнюю полусферу станции.
And I am observing MRM-2 in the upper sphere of the station, which is also on the screen. Current range is 210 meters and range rate is 0.13.
Принято.
Copy.
Есть перезагрузка INPU-1.
INPU-1 reboot confirmed.
Принято.
Copy.
Лончига 10:38. 約6時間. Стейшнまで 200 метров.
The International Space Station and Soyuz flying over the Pacific Ocean, heading toward the northern tip of South America.
Current range is 205 meters and range rate is near zero. We will continue to fly around towards MRM2. Copy.
Just about 50 degrees left in the fly around.
Состояние слова S.
S parameter is 1.51077. Well, this has to do with the fact that the DPO approach and attitude control thrusters were activated.
Soyuz now 200 meters away from the International Space Station.
Current range is 200 meters. Range rate is close to zero.
16:29:19.
This is the final approach time. That's correct, 16:29:19. And most likely it will be performed in automatic mode. Could you please repeat your last?
Скорее всего, по времени пройдет.
Saying that it will be performed automatically on time. Copy.
Большой диаметр СМ 1,2.
The large diameter of the service module is approximately the size of 1.2 squares on the screen. Copy.
К-15
indication is illuminated, copy, and also course is in approach mode. Yes, that's affirmative, course is in approach mode. And we are going to perform the roll maneuver, copy.
The International Space Station and Soyuz now flying over South America.
Current range is 180 meters, range rate is zero. Roll maneuver is about to be completed. Copy. Approach flag set on both vehicles. Copy.
The roll maneuver you just heard orients the solar arrays for the docking position.
Along the x-axis is also confirmed. And we were waiting for a final approach. Current range is 180 meters and range rate 0.7.
And we have confirmation that final approach has been initiated. Russian flight controllers are happy with the alignment. And again, that final approach has been initiated.
Lights are on, and I'm turning on the headlights now.
Фара включена также.
The headlight is on. Copy.
150 meters now separating the Soyuz from its destination.
So the range is 135 meters and the range rate is 0.8 meters per second. Alexander, we might have LOS at 16:34 for about 4 minutes. Copy. At 34 for 4 minutes. Okay, the range is inaudible, 110 meters, and the closing rate is 0.64 meters per second. Copy. One 100 meters is the range, and 0.5 is the closing rate.
90 meters
is the current range. The docking. Interface in the middle of the VSCA periscope and VCO monitor as well, and the range rate is 0.5 meters per second. Is the range, and 0.4 meters per second is the range rate.
Seventy meters
is the range, 0.3 meters per second is the rate, and the panel decided to reboot itself once again. Copy.
Now just under 70 meters separating the Soyuz and the International Space Station.
Meters is the range. The range rate is 0.26. I can see the target in the center of the crosshairs. Copy.
Есть перезагрузка.
Reboot is confirmed. Meters, 0.19 meters per second is the range rate. We're standing by for unintelligible.
Standing by for contact and capture.
Is the range, and the range rate is 0.18 meters per second. Copy, Alexander. SSVP is ready. The probe is extended, the hooks are open, and the transfer hatch is closed. SSVP docking and internal transfer system is ready. Copy. 40 meters is the current range, and the range rate is 0.14 meters per second. I can see the target in the center of the crosshairs, and crosshairs are aligned. Copy. 34 meters is the range, and the rate is 0.9. The target is in the center, and the crosshairs are aligned. Copy.
You can see the Soyuz docking probe on the bottom of your screen.
Thirty meters is the range. And the range rate is 0.08. The target is in the center, crosshairs are aligned. Five meters is the range, and the range rate is 0.09. Copy.
Инструкция есть готовность ССВП.
So we can see the signature that SSVP is ready. Docking and internal transfer system readiness is on. Copy.
Ждем базер.
We are standing for a базер. Twenty-two meters is the range, and the range rate is 0.1 meters per second. Eighteen meters is the range, and the range rate is 0.12. The crosshairs are aligned. The target is one square to the right and lower than the crosshair center. Yes, we can see that. The range is 14 meters. The crosshairs are aligned and the target is in the center. Copy. Twelve meters. The target is in the center. The range rate is 0.12 meters per second. The target width is two squares. Crosshairs are aligned. The target is in the center. Two point five squares is the width of the target. We're standing by for the contact. The crosshairs are aligned. The target is in the center. Standing by for contact. Contact is confirmed. And also we have a docking interface. In
contact and capture confirmed at 7:40 a.m. Central Time, 8:40 a.m. Eastern Time, as the International Space Station and the Soyuz MS-20 flew 260 statute miles over the Atlantic Ocean.
Deactivate the headlight, Alexander. This is Moscow.
Now we'll stand by for the relative motion between the vehicle and the station to slow down before the docking probe is retracted on the Soyuz to enable hooks to close to form a hard mate between the Soyuz and the International Space Station.
Yes, that's correct. 126 in number one, 203 is in the second section. Propellant. 496 kilograms, 496 kilograms. Do you want me to repeat the numbers? No, I have recorded everything. I'm going to page.
Again, docking was confirmed at 7:40 a.m. Central Time, 8:40 a.m. Eastern Time, as the station and the Soyuz MS-20 flew 260 miles over the Atlantic Ocean.
I transferred to the wide-angle lens, and I'm deactivating the headlight. The headlight is off, closing the RPV air supply 1 valve. We confirm RPV 1 is closed, Moscow. And I'm starting the leak check of the modules. Copy, and we'll be standing by for the data from you. For the time 16:42:47, Moscow, the readings are as follows. The SA pressure, 832. BO pressure is 8 to 7. Instrument compartment is 864 millimeters. Copy. So the next data recording will be in 5 minutes. Copy, Moscow.
So now the crew aboard the Soyuz will begin leak checks, reporting those numbers back to teams here on the ground.
Deactivated? Yes. It's a go. Copy.
So
first let us go to SSVP display, and after that you will be able to deactivate TV, okay? I'm on SSVP display. The 9 is not illuminated, Alexander, so it's a go to deactivate television. In work, deactivating TV from input 2 panel. TV is off, OFF. And also please control the SSVP on the display in work. Alexander, please provide running commentary, if possible. Okay, copy.
So
the electrical connector connected or mated is illuminated. The hooks are open. Is not illuminated. We're standing by. For the LED hooks are closed, Moscow. Copy.
And the retraction of the docking probe has been confirmed. Now those hooks will begin driving.
Okay. The hooks are closed. Moscow is confirmed. Copy.
And we now have confirmation that the Soyuz hooks are closed, and we have a hard mate between the Soyuz MS-20 and the International Space Station.
I am standing by for the latches are retracted, LED. Yes, we're standing by for gas 17 command going through.
Yozo.
Yes?
Could you please
okay.
put it back to 350 or charge your tablet?
I see.
Mm-hmm.
Alexander, 5 minutes have passed, so could you please report the data? I'm ready, Moscow. After 5 minutes, the air sub pressure is stable, no change in BO, no change. And in instrument compartment module, also no change. So delta zero. So the next one will be in 10 minutes, and there are people at Baikonur Cosmodrome who would like to talk to you. Copy. The latches are retracted. Moscow signature is on. Copy. Alexander Alexandrovich, this is Rogozin. Good afternoon. Do you copy? Dmitry Olegovich, yes, I copy loud and clear. So, of course, our heartfelt congratulations with the successful docking to the ISS. So how are our Japanese friends feeling?
I'm really fine. This is MZ.
This is MZ. I'm fine. Everything is fine, Dmitry Olegovich. We are working the procedures. Thank you. So please pass on our best regards to them and all the successful mission under your guidance on board the ISS. Copy. Thank you. Guys, so our congratulations with the successful docking. Everything was in auto mode. We were watching you. You know, the time flew so fast. It was just so not ago at all. You know, when we were seeing you off at the Cosmodrome, and now you are on the station. Thank you, Sergei. So Moscow, the SSVP mode is executed, the probe is retracted, and I'm sending the command to deactivate SSVP. Copy, and could you please confirm that S13 is illuminated? Yes, the electrical connectors are mated, is illuminated. Copy, then SSVP should be deactivated. Yes, it is deactivated. So I'm doing the recording in the log. On both NPU. Yes, of course.
Oxygen. Запись журнала сделал.
So the recording of the log is complete, and I'm standing by for the 15-minute leak check data. Yes, we confirm.
Можем выдавать команды G2.
And that completes the Soyuz MS-20's flawless launch to dock that began with its liftoff from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan at 1:38 a.m. Central Time, 2:38 a.m. Eastern Time, carrying veteran cosmonaut Alexander Misurkin and Japanese spaceflight participants Yusaku Maezawa and Yozo Hirano.
Reading, and then you will proceed as per page 68. Copy. In work.
The Soyuz MS-20 lifted off atop a Soyuz 2.1A booster, which performed a series of nominal burns to propel the Soyuz into its preliminary orbit for a four-orbit, six-hour journey to the International Space Station. And the Soyuz docked to the Poisk module on the Russian segment of the International Space Station at 7:40 a.m. Central Time, 8:40 a.m. Eastern Time. As the Soyuz and the station were flying 260 statute miles above the Atlantic Ocean. The docking probe on the Soyuz retracted and hooks closed on both sides of the docking interface to form a hard mate between the Soyuz MS-20 and the International Space Station. After docking just moments ago, the crew received some congratulatory words from Dmitry Rogozin, the head of Roscosmos from Baikonur. The crew will now begin a series of leak checks, which should result in the opening of the hatches between the Soyuz and the International Space Station around 9:35 a.m. Central Time, 10:35 a.m. Eastern. We'll be back on air for hatch opening coverage at 9:15 a.m. Central Time, 10:15 a.m. Eastern Time. We'll follow along as leak and pressure checks are conducted and the repressurization of the vestibule, which is the small passageway between the Soyuz and the station. That will lead to the opening of the hatches and the greetings between the Expedition 66 crew members and the Soyuz crew we see today. So we hope you'll join us back here at 9:15 a.m. Central Time for our hatch opening coverage for the Soyuz MS-20. For now, that'll wrap up our rendezvous and docking coverage. This is Mission Control Houston.
Thank you. Thank you. So space, night, death, darkness, not being there is an essential component of being there. You don't have the one without the other. That's the way being is made up.
Between this year's leaves, last year's leaves, this generation of people and that generation, the interval is in some ways just as important, some ways more important than what it's between.
Thank you.
morning from Mission Control Houston in the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where flight control teams have been on console through the early morning hours working with their counterparts at the Russian Mission Control Center in the town of Korolyov on the outskirts of Moscow for the rendezvous and docking of the Soyuz MS-20 spacecraft, which docked to the Poisk module on the Russian segment of the International Space Station at 7:40 a.m. Central Time, 8:40 a.m. Eastern Time, after completing a four-orbit, six-hour rendezvous that began with the launch of the Soyuz earlier this morning. Soyuz Commander Alexander Misurkin and Japanese spaceflight participants Yusaku Maezawa and Yozo Hirano have conducted leak checks on the Soyuz side of the docking interface. The Soyuz has also transitioned to the International Space Station power and hardline communications. Soon, the small vestibule or passageway between the Soyuz and Poisk module will be pressurized, and those hatches will open. The hatches were scheduled to open around 9:35 a.m. Central Time, but the crew is running just a little bit behind schedule, so we'll continue to monitor their steps for that anticipated hatch opening this morning. Recapping some of the milestones that got the Soyuz MS-20 and its crew to the International Space Station, liftoff occurred on time at 1:38 and 15 seconds a.m. Central Time, 2:38 and 15 seconds a.m. Eastern Time, carrying Misurkin and Japanese spaceflight participants Maezawa and Hirano. They went skyward atop a 2.1A booster. 8 minutes and 46 seconds later, the third stage shutdown and separation happened, shortly followed by the solar arrays and navigational antennas deploying moments later to begin the Soyuz MS-20's four-orbit journey to the International Space Station. About 6 hours later, the Soyuz MS-20 arrived and docked to the Poisk module on the Russian segment of the International Space Station. The docking probe on the Soyuz retracted and hooks closed on both sides of the docking interface to form a hard mate between the Soyuz MS-20 and the International Space Station.
000.
Trash.
Code. Two code. All right, I've made a note.
The crew will spend almost 12 days on the orbital outpost conducting a program of activities that involve showcasing spaceflight back to the people of Japan. Maezawa and Hirano are making their journey into space under a contract between Space Adventures and Roscosmos. Misurkin, Maezawa, and Hirano will not become expedition crew members, but rather Misurkin, a visiting crew member, and Maezawa and Hirano, spaceflight participants.
MG, ready? Close? Yes, please. And let Yozo come in. Yozo, are you ready?
Yes.
I'm ready to copy the measurement results. Yes, Ignat, that's correct, and the pressure has not changed. It is still at 757. Copy, 757. 757, no change here.
view you're getting now from inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where teams are being led by Flight Director Pooja Jesrani.
Okay, thank you. Ignat, INPU 1 опять перезагрузился.
Ignat, INPU 1 has just rebooted yet again. At approximately 18:20, correct?
No, yeah, it, зашел.
Well, I saw it at 18:20. That it was rebooting at that time.
Yozo, did you pack everything to 350 back? Yozo. Yozo, do you pack everything back? Please, yes, because we don't want to put everything back to this back, and we a little bit in the rush.
If you're just joining us, Russian cosmonaut Alexander Misurkin and Japanese spaceflight participants Yusaku Maezawa and Yozo Hirano docked to the International Space Station this morning at 7:40 a.m. Central Time. They're currently running through a series of leak checks on their side of the docking interface, setting the stage for vestibule pressurization and the hatches opening, where they'll be greeted inside the station by the Expedition 66 crew, followed by a welcoming ceremony.
What reason you take the camera, Yozo? Use this strap for your foot. Okay. Ignat, готов принять?
Ignat, are you ready to copy the measurement results? Yes, I'm ready to copy.
Copy. Currently aboard the International Space Station is the Expedition 66 crew. From left to right in this graphic is NASA astronauts Raj Achari and Tom Marshburn, European Space Agency astronaut Matthias Maurer, Roscosmos cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Pyotr Dubrov, and NASA astronauts Kayla Barron and Mark Vandehei.
Okay.
Да, Петр, мы видим тоже картиночку хорошую, да, в принципе, это сам. Ну, давай, сейчас мы будем переключаться, тогда переместись, тогда в этот самый, в МИМ-2, включает там камеру, мы будем переключать сейчас по КРЛ оттуда сигнал.
Включаем
МИМ-2. Ты можешь отключить, если хочешь, и ту камеру, в общем-то, мы уже видели.
Это в 18 канале.
Yes.
If you're just joining us, Misurkin, Maezawa, and Hirano are still running through some leak checks on the Soyuz side of the docking interface. The Soyuz has already transitioned to International Space Station power and hardline communication. One of those next milestones will be when the vestibule or passageway between the Soyuz and Poisk module will be pressurized, leading to hatch opening this morning.
Calling ISS on Space to Ground 2 for Peter. Go ahead and Space to Ground
2.
Peter, I was calling you, but if I am wrong, let me know. Electron in 32M.
Moscow, are you ready to copy another reading?
Is it more convenient for
you? Yes, we are ready to copy.
Does Anton need to do it? I can 7, do it 5, myself, 5. So you want me to return it to 32M mode, correct? Yes. Thank you for the confirmation, Peter.
Copy, Alexander.
Once the Soyuz crew floats through the hatch this morning, they'll make their way to the Zvezda service module, where cameras will be set up ahead of the welcoming ceremony, where some dignitaries in Mission Control Moscow will give congratulatory remarks to the crew.
МКС Москвы в канале СГ-2 для Петра.
по телевидению.
Да, Петь, спасибо, приняли.
Петь, и, короче говоря, можно включить камеру в мим втором?
Камера мим втором включена. Так, на ЦВКУ пока не наблюдаю картинку.
Принято мы тоже.
А коммутация уже выполнена? Может, там надо соединение?
Да, мы скоммутировали. Посмотри, там, может быть, это сам отошло где-то соединение.
Wow, could you check if the connection is plugged in and not loose? Yes, I will try to check it. Yes, this connector is not very good, and so it's quite possible. Okay, yes, I confirm.
Headache already, no?
I make my head spin.
You mean you feel something? No?
Okay.
I see. Right, right. Yes, right. Mm-hmm. Okay, so please take your seat, your cameras, and check that we don't lose anything in 350. I'm not sure, is it pocket? Okay.
Экипаж МКС СУПа Москвы.
МСС Москва, ISS on Space Ground 2, about patch opening.
Are you ready to copy another measurement?
Готов?
Yes. Alexander, I'm ready to copy.
Да, Миш, слушаем.
Go ahead, Михаил.
756.5, no delta.
Preliminary data, preliminary time is 15:50.
So one more measurement is left, correct? Okay. Yes, that's correct. One more.
15:50.
Sounds
good.
So what about the spacesuits? Have you made any progress? They've already changed, into their clothes. So all these spacesuits are doffed, correct? Yes, that's correct. I confirm. But you did not start drying out, correct? Not yet. I will do it later on. Copy.
This is Mission Control Houston. The Soyuz MS-20 has completed its four-orbit, six-hour journey to the International Space Station. Docking came at 7:40 a.m. Central Time. Misurkin, Maezawa, and Hirano are still inside the Soyuz spacecraft, running through some final leak checks on the Soyuz side of the docking interface. Next up, that small vestibule or passageway between the Soyuz and Poisk module will be pressurized for hatches to be opened later this morning.
Камеру можно петь так и оставлять, не трогай ее больше.
You can leave the camera as is, don't touch it anymore.
Саш, давай крайне доверь.
Alexander, are you ready with the last reading? Just a minute. The last reading.
MCC, Moscow, Space Run 2. I copy. I see the video. I took the video cable from the SM and cast camera
756.5. No change.
So this adapter is not working.
Copy, Alexander. Close, как это?
Мы ожидаем очень хорошую картинку. Спасибо большое.
Copy. In work. Video. Thank you very much.
Как это is closed?
11.93.
So, is it a go to perform 11.93? Yes, that's correct. You have a go to perform this step 11.93. It is expedited pressure actualization. Copy that. I have a go to do the expedited pressure equalization.
This view you're getting now inside the Russian segment of the International Space Station inside of the Poisk module. You're looking at the hatchway, and the Soyuz is actually on the other side of this hatchway.
So, the ISS pressure is 765. Okay, so the ISS pressure is 765 millimeters. So the INFO-1 is still in the process of rebooting, so should I help him to do that so that, you know, it happens faster? You know, just deactivate it, Alexander. In work.
Закрываем
РПВ-1. Close РПВ-1, Alexander. I am sending the command to close РПВ-1. It's a S5 command. S5 command? Yes, that's correct. At 51 seconds, the КВД СУОБ is illuminated, and I am sending S6 command. The S6 command is sent at 39 inaudible. So stand by for the SU hatch cover opening by the crew of ISS. Copy. I'm standing by for the hatch cover opening. Alexander, while you are waiting for the hatch opening from the station side, there is a recommendation for you to perform the activation of the vehicle.
Go ahead and speak to ground two.
It's OBT procedure. A procedure orbital flight starting with stage 25.
About the transfer hatch opening. They are telling us we need to work for orbital flight.
Okay, so I'm writing this down. Orbital flight, ODF.
Минуточку, Антон.
Page 25.
The view you are seeing now inside the Russian segment of the International Space Station inside the Poisk module. You're looking at the hatchway, and the Soyuz is on the other side of this hatchway. Anton Shkaplerov was just in the view, getting everything ready on the station side to welcome Misurkin, Maezawa, and Hirano. They'll open up the station side hatch first, before Misurkin opens the Soyuz hatch on his side.
4.5 should be skipped. Copy. It's a gas analyzer, the activation. Yes, I understand. So in the preliminary form 24, I saw the change out of the purification cartridge in BO. So do you give us a go to do that? No, we do not do it, or you do not do it? Copy. You will change out the cartridge in the SR, in descent module. Copy that. So per one should be changed by pair 3 cartridge. Pair 1 to pair 3, copy. Alexander, another reminder, you will have to transfer BMP. Number 18 with 3 EPK and also a fourth filter from MLM. You mean a fort is stored in MLM, correct? Or everything is in MLM? All hardware is in MLM, Alexander. And you will have to transfer it. Okay, so I'm writing this down.
BNP.
BNP unit number 18.
3 EPK.
3 EPK masks. And a fourth filter. Yes, I confirm.
Yes.
Got it, Moscow.
Russian cosmonaut Alexander Misurkin inside of the Soyuz at this hour, communicating with flight controllers in Mission Control Moscow.
Alexander, and another information, Unit 2 should not be installed. I know about that, but thank you for the reminder. In case of the fire, the BO fan should be deactivated manually. Again, for your awareness. Okay, copy. And another reminder. So two spacesuits should be dried in your vehicle and one in the vehicle 749. Copy that. So we're still standing by for the hatch opening, for the OSU hatch opening.
Хорошо.
Standing by.
экипаж МКС Супа Москвы, канале СГ-2 для Антона.
Russian cosmonaut Pyotr Dubrov now in your view on your screen right now, helping to get things set up on the Russian side of the International Space Station.
Операция по открытию люка МИМ-2СУ и сбор документации РК и РС и
ODF procedure for opening the hatch. I can read you the exact item. Okay, stand by one second.
Пункт 4.12.2.
4.12.2, page 4.20.0. Okay, stand by one. And through page, through numbering, which one? And by 1 second, where I'm going to look for it.
Is
page 52.
Rubber. And
which item? 4.12.2.
Okay. Да, все открыл. Спасибо.
Okay, open it. Thank you.
Приняли, Антон.
Copy, Антон.
Station Commander Anton Shkaplerov now back in the view on your screen right now, taking some photos.
МКС Суп Москвы в канале СГ-2 для Петра. Привет, телевидение.
Москва, колония ISS на Space Round 2 for Peter about ISS in the video.
Yes, and connect to ventilation.
Go ahead and space around two. Peter, I have a huge request. Look at the monitor. See if you see Baikonur on the monitor. Okay, check. You can turn the monitor on and turn the camera because we're going to be getting ready. Now we need to make sure we can see all the videos.
Hold on.
To see Moscow ISS on space to ground 2, I see Baikonur and the camera is connected. Okay, I'll leave it as is. Thank you.
And a little bit here also. Please take a seat to Yozo, place. Yes, please, just take a seat. I will switch on the ventilation. Thank you. Do you connect us? Could you please hold this? I believe it's yours.
Oh.
Yeah. От Москвы МКС канал для Александра.
Да, сэр, на связи.
Игнат, как слышишь?
Игнат, how do you call me?
Там...
Слышу
план...
тебя хорошо.
Я просто думал, что...
Ждем открытия крышки со стороны станции.
А, по-прежнему. Все хорошо.
All right, so we're just
18:05.
Я так понял,
поставил.
Экипаж МКС СУПУ Москвы в канале СГ-2.
ISS MCC Moscow on Space to Ground 2.
Игнат, как принял?
Саш, было прерывание связи. Повтори, пожалуйста. МКС СУПУ Москвы.
ISS MCC Moscow on Space to Ground 2. Go ahead and Space to Ground 2.
Петр, ну, в принципе, со всех сторон готов.
Peter, we are overall ready to open the hatch. Copy. We're ready as well, and we can start. Okay, go ahead and start. We're all waiting here at Baikonur. We're here at Baikonur, also looking forward to it.
Видим вас хорошо, выглядите прям.
We see you very well. You look great, and the video quality is awesome.
You can also come to this way.
Station Commander Anton Shkaplerov in the view on your screen now, running through some final milestones before he opens the hatch.
MZ, could you please do the same for this one? MZ, could you do the same for this one?
And the hatch is open on the International Space Station side.
What?
Саша, открой люк со стороны
станции.
Можно выполнять действия в рамке.
Okay, it's not a problem. Я понял.
Так, Петр, Антон, сейчас приступаем к выравниванию.
Peter, Anton, we're starting the pressure equalization from the side of the Soyuz vehicle. Response required. This is SMS-RP speaking.
Так, Антон, Петр идет выравнивание со стороны.
pressure equalization is going on from the side of the Soyuz vehicle.
Vestibule pressurization is now underway.
Итак, открываю ККТ, открываю КВД. ККТ открыт. КВД открыт.
Давление.
Давление.
Так, Антон, с РПСМ.
Again, vestibule pressurization is now underway, setting the stage for the hatch on the Soyuz side to be opened.
Так, ну вы понимаете, да, что как корабельный люк открывается, вы сразу собираетесь по нашему сценарию в СМ. Потому что мы выходим. Да, да, да. С всем экипажем станции, потому что вот время у нас уходит уже на... То есть на 19, на 18.57 уже уходит время, да. Да, да. То есть вот это вот ПАО, которое на 19.00 у вас запланировано. Это я времена ДМВ вам говорю, это время
давления. Numbers, the time is 1657.
Пока идет, пока в
процессе. Пока идет, да. Ну там потом, когда выровняется давление, надо сейчас 2 минуты выждать.
Scorpio, 1657, and the crew will be gathering together. That is correct. 15:55. So there will be TV coverage on arrival. Adjustment. So that the PAO that we are planning to have. So that's what we will have. How copy? Yes, we copy all. So we'll gather together and we'll be ready. Yes, and we see you. That's a great image. At 15:57, we'll have...
Station Commander Anton Shkaplerov back in the view right now, patiently awaiting vestibule pressurization before the hatch on the Soyuz side can be opened for him to welcome the Soyuz MS-20 crew.
So as soon as you have come, you will see an image, a video from Baikonur.
Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Pyotr Dubrov waiting on the station side of the hatch to welcome the new trio aboard the International Space Station.
Давление пока продолжает медленно снижаться по манувакуметру. Пометь, пожалуйста, в 7 часов ровно включил второй скафандр на сушку.
Все, Саш, принято. Спасибо. Два скафандра на сушке.
Yes, I confirm.
We can... Yes, MZ, we don't need your tablets on station. Let's hold it here.
Ignat, this is Alexander. So what is the station pressure? Is it 765? Yes, it is 765, so 165 millimeters. The last we looked, last time we looked. Okay, copy.
У нас пока 768.
And our pressure is 768 millimeters.
And we're currently in a handover between satellites right now, but we should be regaining communications with the station in the next few minutes. Russian cosmonaut Alexander Misurkin and Japanese spaceflight participants Yusaku Maezawa and Yozo Hirano docked to the International Space Station at 7:40 a.m. Central Time.
Copy. Yes, let's wait for 2 minutes.
The crew on the Soyuz side and station side just waiting for that final go to open the hatches on the Soyuz side. Again, the crew will spend almost 12 days on the orbital outpost, conducting a program of activities that involve showcasing spaceflight to the public. Maezawa and Hirano are making their journey into space today under a contract between Space Adventures and Roscosmos. Misurkin, Maezawa, and Hirano will not become expedition crew members, but rather Misurkin, a visiting crew member, and Maezawa and Hirano, spaceflight participants.
Минута вышла, еще минуту жду.
So 1 minute is up. I'm waiting for the other one. The pressure is stable, right, Alexander?
767.
It's 767 now. Copy, Alexander. Continue. Ignite. 2 minutes are up and the pressure is stable. Close KKT. Copy in work. KVD also should be closed.
Station Houston on space.
And
2-4. Tom.
Now you have a go to open the hatch cover. Copy in work.
And Peter and Anton.
So I will release the push to talk button and I'm opening the hatch now. Sasha, you will have to go back to the vehicle later on because you have some actions there to perform.
Go ahead on SG2.
Yes, of course, after the PO event, I guess.
Back in the Poisk module, European Space Agency astronaut Matthias Maurer has joined Anton Shkaplerov.
All right.
We are all here together.
So you will give me the reference to the step that I'm supposed to perform later on? It's page 82, Alexander.
Maurer taking some photos of the crew out of view right now.
A box, you will have to deactivate the purification cartridges in below. Ignat, you know, I won't be able to memorize it all right now. So could you please give me a reference to the step? Okay, step 12.3, page 82, the actions in the box.
Hey, just to let you know, since the
if the crew is on the station. Okay, step 12.3 and ODF.
Slide that to the right.
What procedure is that?
Ultrasound exam is also flexible. We can also slide that to the right.
Did you copy, Ignat? You can open the hatch. Now, you have a go to open the hatch. So I'm recording these steps. So what ODF is that? It is a short profile procedure. Okay. I understand. You won't be waiting for me. All right. So after the PO, I will perform 12.3, and then we'll do the deactivation as per the procedure, the activation of the vehicle. Yes, I confirm everything is correct. Thank you.
Thank you.
The Soyuz hatch opening is now underway. And the Soyuz hatch is now open at 10:11 a.m. Central Time, 11:11 a.m. Eastern Time. First in, Soyuz Commander Alexander Misurkin. Next is spaceflight participant Yusaku Maezawa. And the final crew member to cross the hatch, Yozo Hirano. Again, the Soyuz hatch opened at 10:11 a.m. Central Time. Now 10 residents aboard the International Space Station. With the Soyuz MS-20 crew now aboard the International Space Station, the crew will make their way to the Zvezda service module, where cameras will be set up ahead of the welcoming ceremony, where dignitaries in Mission Control Moscow will give congratulatory remarks to the crew.
Station Moscow, SG-1, Pyotr, Anton, we are transitioning the TV signal to the SM. Copy, we are in the SM. Pyotr, please take the wireless mic and get ready for the event. Wireless mic is ready, monitor is on, camera is on.
So again, next up is the welcoming ceremony, where actually friends and family in Baikonur will be giving congratulatory remarks to the crew. The view now inside this Zvezda service module. The Soyuz MS-20 crew in the front and Soyuz Commander Alexander Misurkin on the right of your screen.
Moscow Station and SG-2, we are ready. Thank you. Hello, friends. I can see you, and I'm so happy to hear you. And we're happy to hear you and see you, and we're happy for the successful docking. Well done. I love you. Thank you, Mom. Thank you. Hooray. Congratulations. Thank you for your support.
ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。ありがとう。
Sasha, you only have 4 minutes. Please pass the mic.
This view of the friends and family in Baikonur.
We love you all. Yes, of course. I love you too. Thank you.
お疲れ様です。えっと、今どんな気持ちですか?お疲れ様です。はい、ありがとう。コサックス56に今どんな気持ちですか?え、着いちゃったよ。もう本当にあったよ、宇宙が。ステーションもあったよ。
Did you hear me? My tall is already high. Growing?
Not yet.
But when you
start.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'll be able to talk to you.
Station Moscow on SG2 for Peter. Please turn on camcorder 200 for MPG streaming. Copy in work. Moving on to SG2 for the crew. We can see you well, and if required, we can continue the conversation. Unfortunately, we cannot send up video now. We can only receive the video from you. Sasha, your mic is not working on SG2. Thank you. We are happy to be with you, friends. How do you copy us? Copy you loud and clear. Okay, Alexander, Anton, we are out of the broadband comm coverage. I think we can complete this event and you can move on to the nominal post-arrival operations. We congratulate you wholeheartedly. We are happy to see the entire crew together. Thank you for your work. Please take time to rest. And Alexander, we still have some ops to do in this Soyuz. So we will continue after that. Now you can deactivate the setup. And Peter, you can restore nominal comm config. Copy, in work. Moving on to SG1. Good copy. Station Moscow on SG2 for Pyotr. You are go to shut down video cameras in the SM, in the MRM. Remove the broadband comm monitor. You will need it tomorrow so you can leave the connectors mated. And we will talk Alexander through it later.
And that concludes the welcoming ceremony. Again, the crew talking with friends and family in Baikonur.
SG1.
Recapping some milestones from today, their journey to the International Space Station began at 1:38 a.m. Central Time, 2:38 a.m. Eastern Time. Weather at the launch pad was 26 degrees Fahrenheit with partly cloudy skies. 8 minutes and 46 seconds after liftoff, third stage shutdown and separation occurred on the Soyuz booster. And just seconds later, the Soyuz automatically commanded its solar arrays and navigational antennas to deploy. The Soyuz performed a series of nominal burns to propel it into its preliminary orbit for a four-orbit, six-hour journey to the International Space Station. And the Soyuz docked to the Poisk module on the Russian segment of the station at 7:40 a.m. Central Time, 8:40 a.m. Eastern. The docking probe on the Soyuz retracted and hooks closed on both sides of the docking interface to form a hard mate between the Soyuz MS-20 and the International Space Station. They did a series of leak checks and pressurized the vestibule before floating through the hatches at 10:11 a.m. Central Time, 11:11 a.m. Eastern. Misurkin, Maezawa, and Hirano were greeted by the Expedition 66 crew and participated in a welcome ceremony that just concluded where they spoke with friends and family in Baikonur. The crew will spend almost 12 days on the orbital outpost conducting a program of activities that involve showcasing spaceflight back to the people of Japan before returning to Earth on December 19th U.S. time, December 20th Kazakhstan time, in the MS-20 vehicle they arrived in today. So with the Soyuz MS-20 and its crew now safely aboard the International Space Station, that'll wrap up our coverage for today. This is Mission Control Houston. Thank you.